3 to 5 seconds. That's as long as you get to grab your audience's attention before they get bored and click away. So you need to know how to write captions that are enticing enough to keep your audience hooked, that will lead to more engagement on social media and even generate more sales for your business. Fortunately, I've discovered an AI-powered app that will save you hours of time and frustration by generating captivating captions in just a few seconds. The app I'm talking about is called OpenRep, and you can use it for free in Canva. And make sure you stick around to the end of this tutorial, because I've got a bonus tip to share with you, which will streamline the entire content creation process from start to finish. So if you're ready to get started, let's dive in to Canva. So starting off on your Canva homepage, you want to go to the sidebar and then click on apps. You could scroll down to locate the app, but to save yourself an awful lot of time and fiddling around, place your cursor in the search bar and then you're going to type OpenRep. And that's the name of the app. There it is. So I'm going to click on OpenRep to open up the app. There it is, OpenRep AI Social Media Caption Generator. So I'm going to click on the icon. Now from here, you're going to select whether you want to use the app in an existing design or use it in a new design. So if you do want to use it in a new design, click on this bar here, scroll down and find the template size you want to work with. But for today, I'm going to use the app in an existing design. So I'm going to click on this bar here and then search for my design under your projects. So I've found the template I want to use, so I'm going to click on it to open it up in the design editor. And here it is. On the left-hand side, in the side column, you'll find all the OpenRep tools you need to start generating captions. Starting at the top, you want to select the goal that you want to achieve with your social media post. So click on the downward arrow and select either informative, to generate website clicks, or to get people to sign up to a newsletter. For now, I'm going to click on website clicks. Underneath, you're now going to select the tone of the captions that are going to be generated. So click on the downward arrow again and scroll down until you find a tone which matches your overall brand. So I'm going to select positive and enthusiastic. The description box underneath is very important. You need to type a description of what your social media post is about, because that will help the app generate the correct sort of captions. You have 1500 characters to use, so that's plenty. As you would do with, say, ChatGPT, try and be succinct and as descriptive as you possibly can, because the more descriptive you are, the better the captions are going to be. Okay, so that's my description written. Underneath the description box, you're going to type out the audience that you're generating the social media post for. You have 250 characters to use in this box here. If there are multiple ways you can describe your audience, separate each description with a comma. I'm just going to scroll down a little bit, and now I'm going to choose the network to which I'm going to share my post. So I'm going to click on the Instagram logo and uncheck the Facebook Pages logo. Scrolling down a little bit more, I'm going to go right down to the bottom and then click on Generate Captions and then wait for the magic to happen. And that took about 3 seconds to generate. My captions have been successfully generated and here they are underneath. I'm just going to click on See More just to reveal all of the text. So this is the text that's going to accompany your beautiful social media image on your selected social media platform. The next step is to copy the text to your clipboard. So just click on copy to clipboard. That's done. And now I'm going to share that bonus with you, which is going to save you so much time and a lot of fiddling and faffing around, because you're going to share this post directly to your social media channel without even having to leave Canva. To do that, you're going to go to the top right-hand corner of your Canva toolbar and click on Share. Now go down to the section at the bottom that says More and the three little dots and click on it. Find the Social section and find the Schedule tool. Now you'll notice that the Schedule tool has a little crown in the top corner, which means that it is a Canva Pro feature. So if you have a free Canva account and you want to use the scheduling tool, then all you need to do is click on the link, which I'll leave underneath in the description box, to give you instant access to a 45-day Canva Pro trial. So I'm going to click on the schedule tool. Next, I'm going to select the date on which I want to share my post. So let's try the 7th of March. Underneath, you're going to select the time you want it to go out. So let's type 11:15. Now click on next. So at the top here, I've scheduled my post for Thursday, 7th of March, 11:15. Underneath, I need to select the channel I want to share this post to. So underneath, you can see I've already connected 3 of my social media channels, LinkedIn, Facebook, and Instagram. If you're unsure how to sync Canva with your social media platforms, I have a very detailed short course available for you for just £10.99, which is roughly $14 for my American friends. And you'll find everything you need to know about Canva's content planner, including things that even I didn't know. So do check it out, and I'll leave the link underneath in the description box. I'm going to click on my Instagram account. Next, underneath, I'm going to select the file type. So I don't want to share a video. It's just a static image. So I'm going to select JPG. Now, underneath in the caption box, I'm going to paste the captions, which I copied to my clipboard. At this stage, you can edit the captions if you don't like the way they read. So I'm just going to take out the speech marks. I'm going to add in some paragraph spacing. And rather than the click the link in the bio call to action, I'm going to change that because I don't really think it works anymore. And I'm going to type something else. Okay. I'm also going to add some more hashtags as well. That's it. And all I've got left to do now is click on schedule. Canva's preparing my design. Just takes a few seconds to do. And now if I click over to view my content planner, I can see that my post has now been scheduled to go out on Thursday, 7th of March at 11:15, and here is my caption. And I can see a handy thumbnail image of my design already in my content planner. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please do give it a thumbs up to support my channel. I'd be really grateful. And check out this entire playlist, which is coming up right now, which is full of more tutorials about all the beautiful Canva AI features from Canva's Magic Studio. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.